evening, space pilots. I'm going to be recording an informational video about how to play the Federation Sea Cruiser. Before we get started, I'd like to note that I've installed a mod that gives a 50-50 chance that any particular human will be male or female, and adds a whole bunch of new names to the names pool. So let's get started really quickly here, and rename our ship to something a little bit easier to pronounce. And just jump right into this. So the main idea of this ship is that you have absolutely no boarding support whatsoever, but you do start with 4 crewmen, which is nice, and you get a clone bay, and on top of that it's a level 2 clone bay. And I guess technically you have this artillery gun that does fire 7 projectiles eventually, but most of the time that's not really going to matter. It's just sort of a backup option for the late game, should we get that far. A lot of how this ship plays depends upon what you get in the first couple of sectors. Well, I guess that's kind of true for a lot of ships, but let's just get into a fight and see what the universe has in store for us. Alright. So one nice thing about this ship is that with the emergency respirators, we can just go ahead and board a ship like this. So this is one of the very few ships that you actually don't care if the enemy has a lethal launcher like this in the first sector, because, as you just noticed, you can destroy one system bar in less than 8 seconds. Another nice thing about this is that due to the combination of the emergency respirators and our teleporter, you can, if you so choose, retrieve your crew using the level 1 teleporter before they suffocate, even if it's a Zoltan. So even if the enemy has like a small bomb or something that destroys this clone bay, you can always retrieve your crew safely. Just something to keep in mind for later. I'm gonna let them destroy this, and the rest should be pretty much a piece of cake, depending upon what this sun destroys. Fortunately, suns can only do a maximum of 1 damage, so even if this hits the clone bay, it's not gonna be a big problem. Alright, this is gonna take a long time to vent out, but I don't want to abandon piloting, so I'm gonna vent this out, and hopefully this Zoltan can help put that out a bit. Zoltan are bad firefighters, but at least they do still firefight just as well as a human does while they're still alive. You need to get in there too, though. I don't know if crew firefighting stacks with venting, but I kind of assume it does. At least it makes me feel a little bit better. Hold on, you need to have your position reassigned eventually, once we get out of here. Let's make sure we don't depower this. There we go. Okay, so my timing is a little bit bad here. We're gonna get hit by this, I think. Because I think the timing for that is really tight. I don't think I'm gonna have time to run in there, but at least I can disable it before it fires another one. Yeah, see, it's already, well, maybe this will arrive on time. Okay, that was a little bit lucky. It was definitely the flak artillery hitting this that shut this off, not my, crewmen. You don't have anything to do, but I guess you can stand in, drones or something. Oh, that's a little mean. Oh well. Alright, so I guess I technically didn't need to board this, but I didn't know that this would do so much damage. Usually it misses a lot more than that. Alright, so that was pretty routine. Took 1 damage. That's pretty average for a ship like that, honestly. And once these guys revive again, I'll set them stations, like we really should do at the start. It doesn't really matter what order they stay on the teleporter, because they kind of get reshuffled. Okay, we got a little bit of a nasty ship here. This is... They're gonna board us. So I guess the question is, this is pretty much always gonna have 3 crew in the first sector. So the question is, do we let them board with 1, have these 2 guys kill 2 on there, and hopefully these guys can take care of it? I'm tempted to let that happen, because if it takes a long time to get rid of the third crewman, at least these two guys might be able to bust up the weapons in the meantime, so I'm gonna let them board. And then we'll board into weapons. And we'll use venting to take care of this guy. We don't really want them to get too, we don't want to vent them too aggressively, because if they get into, piloting and engines, they'll distract our, guys, and we won't get our, manning bonuses for them, so I kind of want to just delay them as long as possible, which means I'm going to vent them very slowly. That'll also give us insurance in case our, doors get hit. I mean, the whole classic, doors broken while doors are open scenario, isn't as much of a problem on this ship due to the clone bay and the oxygen being a little bit further away, but it's still something we don't want to, do if we can get away with. I'm gonna swap positions here because the person in this position is getting beat up on, like, this guy all the time and this guy half of the time, so we want a lot of hit points in the person who's over here. I'm even thinking about going over here, but I think that's kind of a waste of time. They'll get some free hits if we, run away at this point. I'd much rather just kill this person as quickly as possible. Alright, that was lucky. Wasn't expecting a miss there. Alright, so now these two should kill this person fairly quickly. This person isn't going to retreat until, it's too late to matter. And hopefully these guys can get a head start on disabling this thing. Vent oxygen, sure, vent oxygen. Alright, a little unfortunate. We could even... I mean, before this happened, we could have considered boarding with four crewmen to shut this down really fast, but that's obviously out of the question now. So yeah, good. That's what I was trying to do. So now we have all the time in the world to take care of this guy. Manning station gets manned first, even if it's not in the upper left corner. Alright, and that went pretty well, I'd say. I was kind of expecting that to go a little worse. Alright, fortunately all this is going to miss automatically, because they're all dead. Let's power this, and you might need to be cloned soon, so I'll get repair experience on you. Still help temporarily, though. This is a nice trick for forcing the repair on one person. You get the two-man repair bonus, but then you can move this guy out, force this person to do the last bit of repair, and that guarantees that you know, your Mantis doesn't steal the repair experience or whatever. Alright, so engines, yeah, that's not really enough to make you worth me keep alive, so... We'll just, grow a new engineer. And, yeah, you, again, for the same reason, we'll grow a new Mantis, too. So, the emergency respirators make this take a little bit longer, so that's a little bit of a downside, but it's, you know, worth the wait. If it takes me a long time to clone, like, four, crew members, I'll probably cut it out. You know, just so that you guys don't have to wait so long. Okay, so now we have our 35 scrap. I will go ahead and buy this immediately. Having this extra shield bar, even though it's half of a shield bar and you can't really power it, it does give you, you know, if it gets taken down by one damage, you still have that shield bar up. In addition, you can actually power the half bar of shield with a Zoltan crewman, and that can be useful sometimes. I might get to show off how that can be useful later. Another nice thing about this ship is that you can, if necessary, do this for certain other ion immunization tricks. But that's probably not going to come up all that often. We could definitely go all of Sector 1 without seeing that. Okay, good. No offensive drones to go with that. If there was a Combat 1 drone in addition to that, that would be pretty scary. Fortunately, these guys don't have a med bay. I'm assuming that since I can see this, they probably just have, like, another system repair drone or something. So let's go ahead and see. Yeah, as I suspected. Fortunately, no anti-personnel drone. Some enemy ships in the first sector can have 3 powers, so they could have had one. They just didn't in this case. So unfortunately, this is probably going to hurt us, but then they probably is going to hurt us all that badly in subsequent volleys. So really what we want to do is just take down the crew as quickly as possible. Since we're not going to be able to dodge this very well anyway due to our low engine rating. So I'm really tempted to just go ahead and board with these guys as soon as this is ready. So in the meantime, we don't want to waste time beating up that system repair drone. I just was just scouting there. So let's the good old-fashioned fighting and try and kill these guys as quickly as possible. Maybe we can dodge this. Okay, that's a little nasty, but fortunately I'm not in as much of a hurry to repair that as I would be otherwise. Still 10 more seconds before this is ready. Alright, so you killed that. You got the advantage here. Who's left? Alright, I think now I can go ahead and just kind of ignore that bit. Alright, so yeah, see, after a while these two weapons desynchronize. Oh, very nice, very nice. Alright, so this is a little bit tricky. Obviously we got a human instead of like a rockman or a mantis, so I do have to think about this a little bit more carefully. But I am really tempted to just go with mantis plus human instead of mantis plus Zoltan. Zoltan suicide tricks are handy on the other ship, especially if you get into big brawls or you're like fighting like 3 or 4 crewmen in the same room where that bonus gets multiplied. But I'd much rather just have the power on my own ship. On the other hand, having a human remain on board would be pretty handy for repair purposes. Like just send a Mantis and Zoltan there, have a Zoltan at home, and then have a free roaming human repairman. That could be pretty handy. On the other hand, in the early game, all the important stuff to repair is, like, the clone bay, the, you know, all of these 4 systems plus the teleporter, which is all on this side of the ship anyway. So it isn't really as important to have a free roaming crewman, because usually these guys are the people who are just going to be repairing the systems anyway. So I don't know, it's kind of a toss-up, but I think I'm just going to go with Mantis plus Human, because that's a lot more straightforward than Mantis plus Zoltan. Plus, that lets me keep the 2 Zoltan at home if I need to, like, simultaneously have the shields at 2 Zoltan power, plus have a competent boarding party. So, okay. So now that I've gotten out of the way, like, explaining a whole bunch of stuff during these 3 beacons, hopefully I can get through the rest of Sector 1 a lot faster. Yeah, should be no problem. Here's another hidden benefit, is now I can stay on board a little bit longer. Alright, so I should be able to take this down before it fires, I think. Might be close. Alright, good. And now we have someone manning shields, which should help a little bit in case it, alright. I was a little afraid of something like that happening. With manned shields, there's slightly less chance that'll happen, but as you saw, sometimes that'll happen anyway. Which is why it's important we actually beat up this drone. Alright, should be pretty straightforward from here. We just need good ol' artillery flak to speed this up a little bit. It's probably worthwhile sending them on board just one more time, though. One nice thing about auto ships is that you tend to get like net profit of boarding skills, boarding them, since you tend to sabotage at least three bars, which means one of your crewmen is getting like two worth of experience, and one of them is getting one. All right, how much damage does this do? Pretty good damage. Yeah, it's worthwhile to send them on board again, just for that reason. And maybe if we're lucky, they can just do both of the hull damage, and we don't have to wait 50 seconds for the next one. Aw, just two. Oh well. We still broke even on that on average. In fact, I don't even really care all that much how much boarding experience the human gets. I more care about boarding skill on the Mantis, because that's multiplicative. Alright, so we've got enough for level 2 shields. That will help a lot. In fact, since I've got the 15 scrap already, I'll go ahead and buy this. It's kind of questionable which upgrade you want to get next, but usually I'm going to go with engines, just because in dire situations you can redirect all power to shields and engines, and that'll help a lot against things like Burst Laser 2 and whatnot. Alright, so sector layout's pretty good. I should be able to pretty much zigzag among all this stuff and get out with plenty of time. Don't have to worry about bottlenecks, so should be okay. I can pretty much just go any which way. So this event, this is one aspect of FTL I don't really like all that much, is you kind of have to memorize which events are going to kill off your crew and in what manner they're going to do that. In particular, this one has a disease on it, so it's not safe to go on there, even though we have a clone bay. So I'm going to go ahead and scrap some of the debris here. You have to either know stuff like that, or just kind of accept the fact that some of your crew are going to just die for random reasons. And I kind of wish there was some better way of doing it, but, I mean, that's just kind of one aspect of the FTL event reward structure, is some events are going to have the risk of crew death, and that's really the only way of, one of the only ways of penalizing you for, having a random penalty. Alright, so now that I've said my piece on that, we can just get out of here. Alright, you should be no problem at all. Fortunately, enemy clone bays are not really a big problem on this ship. Enemy med bays are a little bit more so, but even that isn't such a huge problem as long as you have time. That's really the big aspect of this. This ship would be so much more of a pain if it had a missile, but since we don't care about them hitting us at all, we can just board them with as many as we want. I might want to demonstrate just how to deal with this clone bay with just two crewmen, though. Because that'll be useful for later. Okay, so you're at pretty good health, you're at low health. So you are going to go over to shields. And you can keep... Actually, you should stay here. I shouldn't have done that, but you'll see. Alright, so now that someone is cloned, you go over to shields. That distracts them out of there because they think shields is more important a priority than the clone bay, and this person preserves the partial destruction progress on the bar. It's a lot easier to see this on your own ship, or if you have the level 4 sensors, but kind of like partial repair progress, there's also partial sabotage progress. Anyway, so what I should have done was kept both of the crewmen in there for all the time. I wasted a little bit by moving him in and out again. But anyway, this should work. Okay, it's a level 2 clone bay. That's actually a bit more of a problem. Are they going to win that? That's highly questionable. Alright, so fortunately, I don't have to actually worry about this enemy ship hurting us, so I can just go ahead and, send in some backup orders. Alright, you guys get in there. Alright, there we go. Okay, that's interesting. I didn't even think about that. One interesting aspect of this game is that enemy ships do sometimes surrender, but only when you actually damage their hull. So because I actually accidentally let this fire, I have an actual offer to consider here. The shield charge booster doesn't really matter in the early game all that much. I know I was just talking about how shield recharge rate helps against drones and beams and whatnot. But honestly, if I were to take this, this is early game scrap right here. That said, it's not insignificant. This was not a slaver ship or anything like that. This is just like a normal event. So if I'm going to crew kill them, I'm just pulling from default rewards, which, to be fair, could have like a crewman or a weapon in them. But most of the time it doesn't. Most of the time it's just like slightly more scrap or slightly more fuel. So most of the time, if I refuse to surrender, I'm just getting like 15 to 20 scrap or something. Maybe not even that. And this is still Sector 1. So I think most of the time, like, I think this is better on average. This could get me a slightly better reward, but you really want to play the averages. So with that in mind, I'm going to go ahead and take this 3 fuel and a decent amount of scrap and this augment, which will help us for a few battles, and then we'll probably sell it. And who knows, it might actually save us some damage. So, good job. You chaps have actually successfully bought your lives, and for that you should be very thankful. It's a rough universe, and if you're going to negotiate for your lives successfully, you have to offer something that's actually really important. So, unlike all the others, you know, you get to survive today, good sir. Hopefully you will consider the errors of your ways. Alright, all good, all good. Okay, this is normally a pretty good event, but we've got plenty of fuel. We've got way more important things to worry about than buying more fuel. So that's that. Okay, another auto scout. This one has hacking, though, so it's pretty much, I mean, this isn't enough to actually dissuade us from fighting this. We're gonna fight this, or at least try to. So let's just go ahead and start that. Alright, like I thought. So, you usually want to wait and see what this hits, because you don't know what level of hacking it is, and you don't know where it's gonna land. Alright, so let's just see. Assuming it doesn't hit anything important, we're just going to port weapons, but we'll see first. I want to see where it hits, though. Alright, teleport. So this is why you don't board immediately. Because if you do board immediately, it will pull your guys back, and it'll be on cooldown. But because I didn't do that, it will not be on cooldown. Plus, I don't have power trapped in there, because I didn't leave any in there. If there were any left in there, I would not be able to pull it out. That'll be hacked for a little while, then it'll turn off. Alright, so now it's done. So now it's not on cooldown because it didn't actually activate. So now we can board immediately. Alright, so I'll be, actually, one trick I can do is, here we go. Now we've got 2 shields. Alright, so that was handy. Probably saved us damage there. So, yeah, again, this is, I mean, this is kind of an inconsistency. It doesn't really work the same way on weapons, but you can fill up half of a shield bar like that. So, alright. Was kind of expecting that to happen, but we got the important thing done. So you can see that this time it is actually on cooldown, so... Again, little tiny differences like that can make a, well, a larger difference. Alright, what do we got? Flak 2. Flak artillery, excuse me. Yeah, that's worthwhile. I want to take that down. You guys did not actually die, though. Are you going to last long enough to... I think you can last long enough to do one bar. 40%, well, never mind, then. Oh yeah, that's because I was on cooldown. I should have waited for another hacking cycle. Oh well. Fortunately, that's not gonna matter. So, yeah, you can see that because it activated, and then, like, see, it's on 15 seconds of cooldown, which is, maybe it starts going on cooldown during the hacking cycle. It should be on, like, 4. I think this is fine, actually. Never mind. Never mind. So what I should be doing is just waiting out the cooldown, waiting for it to hack again, and then boarding. So see, it's gonna hack again pretty soon, which is what I ran into last time. Alright, so now I'll wait for this to finish, and then I'll... maybe this will actually make that irrelevant, I don't know. But I'm getting a little bit nervous about it actually getting the weapons up, so I'll go ahead and do this. Alright, see, a lot of that actually missed. It's possible it might not have actually taken that down. So, whatever. I mean, if they lost skill, they lost skill. It's not a huge deal. Alright, so I think since I bought, like, 2 shields and 1 engine without buying any power, it's probably a good idea to buy some power now. Alright, so so that extra crewman is gonna help a whole lot, especially in, mid-game, but, we still don't have any actual boarding support. I'm hoping to run into a medbay ship to kind of show off, why medbays are a problem on this ship. We also haven't run into anybody who's trying to run away, which can also be really annoying in Sector 1. Looks like we've got, 3 jumps, so I will go ahead and go distress this exit, I think. Don't really need more power right now. This is cannibals, so I can go ahead and board and investigate. Oh, Ariel's gone, but Ariel's back. Unfortunately, we didn't, get to fight boarders or even get a new crewman there, but, oh well. So yeah, like I said, we don't really need any more power. This is enough power. We can divert more power to the clone bay, or divert power from, this to that. This is enough power for now. So I guess what I'm saving up for is I'm thinking about piloting 2, or maybe engines 4. Those are pretty much what's on the docket right now, but I kind of want to save my scrap and go to Sector 2 and see what Sector 2 has for now. Piloting 2 is pretty important. I like it a whole lot. I get it a lot earlier than a lot of other people do, but at the same time, it's not really the end-all be-all. Alright, so this ship is trying to run away. And one thing about ships that are trying to run away is most of their escape timers are much shorter than 50 seconds. So unless you, like, destroy their piloting or otherwise delay their FTL charging, this is way too slow to be of any use whatsoever. That said, I'll keep it fired up anyway just because it's going to help me destroy this faster. So in the meantime, what we need to do is take out their piloting. Now, piloting is usually only level 1 or level 2 in the opening sector. I don't think I've ever seen it be piloting 3, whereas engines can definitely be level 3. So I will go ahead and board piloting, since that usually has fewer system bars. In the meantime, we should be able to weather the attacks from this stuff and then take it down. Again, the shield recharge rate is going to help a lot here. So unfortunately, yeah, it's better to just let these guys die, than to, take them back and then take them there, because that's gonna take, like, 40 whole seconds anyway. Whereas it's, not gonna take all that long for, them to, die and then clone and then come back, and then they'll be at full, health. So in the meantime, we've delayed their stuff, and then we just have to wait for them to come back, and then we can start trashing this stuff so that we don't get any lucky damage from them. If I wanted to, I could board right away, but I'm not really feeling that. Okay, they actually got that online. Unfortunately, this is gonna fire, so hopefully that'll help. Alright, that's quite nice, quite nice. thinking about what to do now. They've already got that offline. It's going to be a long time before this happens. I can't do 3 hull damage. So what I'm thinking about doing is just taking down their engines again. I kind of want a little bit of insurance in case this comes online again. On the other hand, we can shut this off pretty quickly, so I just kind of want to guarantee I don't take any more damage. I'm pretty sure I've got this under control, especially since this has spent a lot of time being disabled. So I don't think they're in that much danger of jumping away on us. Just in case, though, I'm going to get another boarding party ready. You guys don't even really have any skills to speak of, so it's okay if I just go ahead and board with you guys immediately. You only need to do 1 bar of damage. This might actually regenerate, though. But I'm pretty sure, yeah, you guys can do 2 system bars anyway. And everybody will come right back on board. I mean, who needs a teleporter when you have a clone bay? Alright, I guess I'll be right back. Okay. I'm a little bit hesitant to do that, because if we only have 3 missiles, then it's going to be a lot less practical to use any bombs we should happen to be able to buy. So I'm going to go ahead and save my missiles. The rewards from that are usually pretty minor anyway, so I think we can get away without doing that. Alright, Zoltan controlled is tempting because Zoltans are really easy to beat up, and sometimes they don't have med bays, but I'm going to go ahead and go to civilian sectors so you can fight fewer Zoltan ships, and if we happen to fight rebels or med bays or whatnot, then that's just part of dealing with the difficulties of this ship. Alright, so let's see what we've got. We've got a nice big nebula. That's kind of what I was thinking about when I was putting off the piloting 2 upgrade. I'm definitely not even going to bother go to this quest. That's only like a 50-50 chance at a fight, and it's at the end of a dead end, so that's basically worse than a regular beacon for me at this point. So sorry, folks, I'm not going to investigate that Mantis station. You should have thought of that before you just gave me scrap up front. But I'll certainly take it. Maybe I can redirect the Rebel fleet to take care of that old Mantis problem for you fine folks. But in the meantime, I've got to go help out the Federation. So I'm thinking about distress, then jump around in here a whole lot. Something like that, maybe. So with that in mind, distress, there's not really anything I can upgrade to be better at that. So I'll just go ahead and get my piloting right away in case this distress is a fight. It is, alright, so I don't think I have any blue options for this. Yeah, I don't have any blue options. So the question is, do I want a coin flip of 5 hull damage for really lousy rewards? I think I'd rather just keep my hull intact in case I run into a nasty ship. Sometimes that's worth taking a coin flip on in the later sectors, but by the later sectors, you usually have a blue option to deal with that anyway, though. So, eh. Kind of depends on how your ship is doing. I might have tried it if I was at full hull, but I'd rather just keep my hull if I can. So definitely not going to that store. The respirators are far too important to keep right now, and the shield charge booster is not really worth all that much scrap. So there's just not really any reason to go to it. Alright, where are you guys? And some people in the clone bay, you guys deal with that. Yeah, okay, outnumbered. Can swap some of these people back and forth. Shouldn't be a big deal. In fact, you take a little bit less damage. I want to kind of swap people out so that they take about even amounts of damage, so that way the clone bay will heal up everyone. Yeah, you've taken enough damage. You can get it now. And I might grow a new Mantis anyway. The thing is about nebula sectors, though, is that they have a lot of empty beacons in them. So, with your clone bay, you tend to kind of heal up people to full anyway if they don't participate in the fight. That said, though, like I keep saying, crew excuse me, experience is not really all that important. If I clone these guys, they're still going to be regular level 1 boarders anyway, and it's going to delay them getting to green a little bit, but that doesn't really make all that much of a difference. I would much rather them be at full health in case we jump immediately to a pirate or something. These guys, in the meantime, though, they're close enough to full health that the clone base should patch them right up. Alright, like I thought. Okay, this, are they trying to... Yes, they are trying to jump away. Sometimes they aren't, but most of the time when you see that, they are trying to jump away. Fortunately, this is a connected ship, so, so we'll do this, and we'll do this. And, now they can't hurt us at all, and we should be able to, take care of them no problem. Alright, they just had level 1 piloting. I'll go beat up engines, that should make it a bit easier. Might as well train our pilot a bit, I guess. Alright, so again, due to flak spread and, the small shape of these rooms, this is probably not going to take them out, but we should be okay. Especially since we destroyed the engines, so yeah, they're still delayed. And they can't dodge any of the shots that'll actually hit their ship. So that's nice. Okay. That was also suspiciously good timing. So is it worthwhile to send these guys to their death to just to get that one last full bit? Yeah, that's alright. Like I said before, it's okay. They'll be okay. So, you know, Ariel got one bit of experience, but then they'll lose one, so they'll come out even, and Bjorn will lose a bit, but he'll get trained up well enough. Or maybe he'll get to retire from boarding duty if we get another crewman. But they're doing their jobs. So once again, another uneventful trip. I'm gonna try and save a little bit of scrap, though. In case we run into a store, I would like to be able to buy something like a small bomb, or even like a burst laser 1 or something. That would make a really big difference. Okay, so we've got a Mantis ship. For some reason, these ships can have like a minimum of 1 weapons bar instead of like 2. So sometimes you run into ships like this that basically have no chance of hurting you. I've even seen ones that just had like a ion stunner instead of a laser, which is pretty pathetic if you ask me. So I will go ahead and let these guys board, and then I will board the clone bay. And we're going to do something kind of similar to that pirate we saw earlier. Do I want to bother venting the doors? Yeah, sure. I'm a little lazy, I'm going to let them come to me. Oh, they only had 2 crew, too, because this is a Mantis ship, that's right. Alright, so yeah, you guys all, alright. Everyone out, you go to the upper left, and yeah, now you go. And then equalize the oxygen here, I guess. Meantime, you guys will beat up that, and, yeah, we're still fighting against one laser. So, yeah, I mean, I guess this ship might be a threat to civilian shuttles, but, yeah, this is kind of pathetic. Alright, that was no problem. So, yeah, still saving my money, I think. I could probably get one more power. That's probably a good idea on average. Yeah, I'll go ahead and do that, because that'll give me 5 power and ion storms instead of 4, which could make a big difference. Okay. Little bit scarier, but no med bay, so... They might hack our teleporter, but that's about all they can really do. Alright. Oxygen is a bit of a problem, but we really should be done killing them before that actually is a problem. It is a little low because I've been stealing power from oxygen for a while. In fact, I gotta defend against this though, because this could actually hurt us. In fact, since it's gonna take a long time, I can't really do the same Dalton power trick I did last time. This is gonna hit at about like these are so close together, it's gonna take too long for the shields to recharge them anyway, so I'd much rather just have to dodge. Alright, so now I will go ahead and board this. And I guess you need to get on piloting. Oh, I guess there were only two crewmen, or something. I have to admit I wasn't paying that close attention to the enemy ship. Well, whatever. I mean, if there were more crewmen, I would have been able to, board them and overwhelm them, and I might have taken, like, one more damage. But, that's okay. So, you really do want to keep this as, like, a, like, in the early game, your advantage is the large amount of crew you have. Sometimes it is important to just abandon your posts and just everyone invade the enemy ship and just overwhelm them. And that can be pretty important, especially in cases like level 2 medbay or anti-personnel drone, or them trying to escape. Fortunately, we've been very lucky with the kinds of enemy encounters we've been running into. Game's been pretty generous with giving us some easy fights. I should have cloned Ariel. Fortunately, game is not going to punish me for that one. So, again, even though they're at really good health, I am going to go ahead and clone them anyway, because, again, they'll get to green status eventually. They are averaging, net combat skill gain, despite how often I'm cloning them, just because they're killing so many crew and sabotaging so many systems. And it's just more important to have them at full health, just so that they can, fight evenly with enemy crew in there. Alright. So, distress, I'm not really that keen on going to it immediately. I can go ahead and just get some more jumps, and I'll get to that eventually. So, you guys hold on for another, 3 millennia, and I'll get to you when I get to you. This is tempting. Drone parts are obviously, they tend to be rewarded in smaller amounts than missiles, so an even trade like this tends to work out in your favor. But again, I'm probably more likely to run into a random bomb weapon than I am to by hacking this early, so I'm gonna go ahead and ignore that. These are fine levels, I don't want to mess with them. And I'll go ahead and get one more nebula, might be a good nebula beacon. It's not, but it could have been that plasma storm event that you've probably already heard about. So now, here's an actual decision. I do have the shield charge booster to sell. So I believe that's like 25 scraps, so I'm going to end up with like 68 if I go to that store. Which means I could buy something like a small bomb or a burst laser 1 or some other weak weapon that, still does something. Because you have to keep in mind that we have not run into a ship with Zoltan shields yet, and Zoltan shield ships are the real problem here, because our only method of dealing hull damage is this stupid flag gun. Well, I shouldn't say it's stupid, but it is really slow, and you do not want to be relying upon that when the enemy Zoltan ship is pounding you with missiles over and over again. So even something like an Ion Blast 1 is a huge difference if you can pick it up in a store. That said, it's just as likely that it could have something like Burst Laser 3, Healing Burst, and, Charge Laser 2, just to throw out some names here. So, I really don't think we actually have enough scrap to make this store worthwhile. So, Sector 2, we can still kind of put up with things using our regular tactics, and we may just get a free weapon anyway, so I'm not that tempted to go to the store right now, especially when we just have one thing to sell. So, I will go ahead and ignore. Meantime, we've got plenty of jumps still, because of all that time we spent in the nebula. Okay, alright, another ship with hacking. Let's see what it hits. Might hit something else this time. Alright, engines. We still don't care about that, so I'll go ahead and board even before that hits. We might be able to punch down that missile before it fires. And even if we don't, we'll punch it down before it fires a second, that's for sure. Alright, I still don't really get how it chooses to depower systems. I believe that this is slot number one, like the leftmost slot for the AI, and this is slot number two. Which makes me think it would have depowered this one power laser first before this missile anyway. But it depowered the missile first. And then, due to some other power reallocation rules, it decided to turn that back on and turn this off. But I don't really get why it turned this one off first. This is probably something I can figure out with level 4 sensors, but it's just something weird I noticed. Anyway, so that helps confirm that it's a one-power missile, so that's a lot better than an Artemis missile, of course. Okay, actually it was an Artemis missile, so why did it turn that one off instead of the laser then? I don't really get it. Alright, it missed. Even if it had hit the, clone bay, though, I would have been able to retrieve my crew with the teleport. Assuming that the solar flare also shut that off, but, that's stacking a lot of chances together. 22% evade, that's pretty lucky. I mean, that will happen 22% of the time. You will dodge the missile. It just doesn't happen all that. You guys go ahead and break that, too. We do want to get out of here faster. We don't need the ship shutting down our, charge like that. Fortunately, we didn't actually take any cold damage from that. That's cool. So I'll go ahead and triple vent this fire. That should help. So, yes, crew also continue sabotaging during their death animation, which is funny. We should actually oxygenate that. Let's see what we hit with this barrage. Alright, not good, but it's something. So, yeah, this is gonna take long enough, and we're probably gonna get another. I'm tempted to bash down the shields to see how much damage the solar flare will do to their systems, but I think it's more consistent to just board weapons and keep that suppressed. I don't want them turning on that missile launcher again if they get two bars of repair. So we're probably going to take another solar flare, but so be it. That's what happens when you don't have any direct hull-damaging weapons. And we weren't going to get that shield down in time for the solar flare anyway. Okay, that's a little unlucky, but we don't have to... Well, we're going to have to repair that soon anyway, so alright, you guys go fix that. So that way you guys can get a head start on repairing this thing, and that way it'll be repaired when we jump out of here. I think we're gonna have to... Oh, are they gonna get this down in time? Are they? I think they will, actually. Alright, very nice, very nice. And sensors, I'll go ahead and jump. I'm okay with jumping out of there. Hopefully this will take out that last bit of hull, and we can jump out of here before the next flare. Alright, very nice. And we should be able to wait for this person to clone before we jump out. In fact, you can even run over the sensor to see if we can get that fixed. I mean, not that I really care about repair experience. Repair experience is so worthless. Okay, not going to that store. So I'll jump here. They will fix that while the jump is happening. And that is a terrible deal. Forget that. Alright. Okay, free weapon. Okay. That's not really what I meant, but, I'll take it. So that gives us options, at least. Alright, so... it's probably worthwhile getting that online. Yeah, especially since I can do that right now. Alright. That gives us options, at least. Okay. Alright, acceptable. So, again, you tend to get a free weapon by, like, Sector 3 or 4. I don't want to say, like, on average, because, a lot of these things depend upon, like, how many ships you fight, what sectors you go to, what kind of neutral events you run into, but you tend to get a free weapon because every enemy ship you kill with default rewards has a 1/8 chance of giving you a free weapon. And there are other, like, quests and neutral events you can run to that can also get you a free weapon. You tend to figure these things out as you play more and more often, but, you can sometimes get a free weapon with this ship without having to buy it. It isn't that unusual to get something for free. That happens a lot on other ships, too, but not nearly as much on the gunships, since you're not getting those crew kill rewards as often. So, even if we hadn't gotten that Iron Blast 2 for free, we probably would have been able to buy another weapon in Sector 3 or so. So, yeah, that's definitely a boon. I'm certainly not going to look this gift horse in the mouth. Excuse me. Let me try and pronounce things a little bit more carefully here from now on. Getting a little low on fuel, though. I guess we might have to go to a store whether we want to or not. Now that we don't have a missile weapon, and we're probably not going to get one for a while, I will go ahead and give them the missiles, especially since they might give us fuel. They don't give us fuel, but that's compensation enough. That'll go towards fuel in the next sector. Alright, so what have we got? Zoltan Homeworld. It's very interesting. Uncharted Nebula. Uncharted Nebula is definitely the safe option, since that you just run into, like, pirates and auto ships and stuff like that. And as I've shown, auto ships are no problem for this ship, really. They start becoming a problem in, like, Sector 4 and 5 when their weapons get scary and you can't really shut them down just through boarding alone. But for now, they're weak enough that just boarding them is enough of a countermeasure. I think I'm going to go to the Zoltan Homeworlds. I don't tend to do this on this ship just because Zoltan shields are that nasty, but because we've got the Ion Blast 2, I'm feeling a little bit more confident about that. So, yeah, let's take them on.